MPEG DASH, or Dynamic Adaptive Streaming over HTTP, is basically an adaptive bitrate streaming protocol. That means if your internet speed is lower, then the video quality will automatically be decreased, like YouTube. Or if your internet speed is very high, then automatically the player will select the best available format. MPEG DASH is a protocol or some guideline to play video on the internet, on your website, or for live streaming, or to build some OTT platform like Netflix. Normally, we can host MP4 video on our website and play that with HTML. So why do we need MPEG DASH? We use MPEG DASH because it provides us lots of features and control over the media player. MPEG DASH provides the adaptive bitrate streaming, and if you want to apply digital rights management, you can also do that. MPEG DASH provides additional security and DRM support. It is also widely supported in all devices, including Android and Chrome browser. And this is also standardized by ISO as an open source audio and video streaming protocol. So these are the few things why you will be using MPEG DASH on your website or on your app. Now we'll see how it works. Let's say you have a video file, an MP4 file, and you want to serve it on your website using MPEG DASH protocol. So the first thing you have to do is you have to transcode the MP4 file according to MPEG DASH guideline, and you have to generate a MPD file, which is basically XML based manifest file for MPEG DASH. And storing all the video segments on your website, you have to serve the MPEG DASH file, which is actually keeping the reference of all segments. Then you have to implement a player which will read the manifest file and access the transcoded video segments, and the player will be playing the video. Now I'll show you a sample example on how MPEG DASH practically work. Here I have a sample input MP4 file which will be serving on my local host, on my local server, using MPEG DASH protocol. So first thing is to transcode this video according to MPEG DASH guideline and generate the MPD manifest file. I'll do that using FFmpeg or FFmpeg that is already installed on my Windows computer. So if you don't have FFmpeg installed, you need to install that one on your computer to do this thing. I've also made a tutorial on how to install FFmpeg on your Windows computer. You can watch that. I'm going to FFmpeg website for MPEG DASH documentation. So this is the link. I have already given this on the description. So here is a command. This command will take the sample MP4 video as input and will also transcode it into two different formats. Then it will generate a MPD file, which is, as I mentioned, an XML file. I'm copying this command from here and will make it prepared for my sample input file. The input file is named input.mp4, so I'm changing it input.mp4, and finally this will be the path to my MPD manifest file. So I'm naming it output_manifest.mpd, and I'll run this command here. So I'm creating a new folder named dash streaming. So after preparing the folder, I'm writing it like current directory, then -_streaming. So my command is ready to prepare the dash manifest and segments. So I'm copying the full command and opening terminal in this directory, and here I'm pasting the command and pressing enter. It's saying the libfdkac codec is unknown. So what I can do here, I can change it to only ASC, advanced audio codec. Pasting the command again and pressing enter. Now the transcoding just begun. It will take some time. Now the processing is complete. If I go to the directory, I can see that new small segment of the video and also a manifest file. If I open this on Notepad, I will see. Since I will be serving this MPEG DASH protocol stream from my local host, from my local server, I have to place this on my server. So I am cutting the folder, and I have XAMPP, which also comes with Apache server. My Apache server is currently running, and I'll go to the htdoc folder of my XAMPP, and I'll paste the folder here. So now I can access the folder and files inside the folder by localhost slash dash streaming slash the MPD file. So if I go to Google Chrome and try the link, this one, localhost slash dash underscore streaming slash output underscore manifest. So the video is playing. The video is playing because I have installed a extension named dash player. If I remove the extension and then try to access or play the MPT file, then it will show the XML file. So the extension is basically a dash player. So when you work with dash, you have to work both in server side and also in client side with a player, because dash manifest file or dash stream is normally not supported by default on Chrome or any other browser, but supported based on MSC based media player like Shaka player or Exo player in Android. So this extension is basically the player implementation of the protocol. So what you have to do is you have to go to Chrome web store and install the extension. Name of the extension is native MPG dash plus HLS playback. You have to add this on your Chrome, and after adding the extension to your browser, if you refresh the page, the video is playing. So this is a very beginner level tutorial for MPG Dash. So if you are very new in this, I hope this video will make some sense to you. Thank you so much for watching.